During the last 1,000 years, what section of California do you think produced the most volcanic eruptions? Surprisingly enough, the answer is not the north-northeast of the state, containing the southernmost extent of the Cascade Mountain Range. And this is despite the fact that it contains Mount Shasta, the Medicine Lake Shield Volcano, and Lassen Peak, which specifically last erupted in 1917, merely 107 years ago. Altogether, these volcanoes only erupted 6 times during the last 1,000 years. However, if we move towards the very eastern section of the state, we run into a 35-mile-long chain of activity of primarily highly viscous and explosively formed volcanic vents that stretch from several miles south of the town of Mammoth Lakes all the way north to the northwesternmost section of Mono Lake's shoreline. This chain of activity, due to variations in composition, distinct magmatic sources, and dates when they were most active, represent not one, but 3 separate still active volcanoes. Mammoth Mountain is in the south, having erupted once in the last millennia. Mono-Inyo encompasses the middle section, having erupted 3 times in the last millennia. And the little-known Mono Lake complex lies to the north, having itself erupted 3 times in the last 1,000 years. In this entire chain, the youngest volcanic activity occurred at the aforementioned little-known Mono Lake complex, which produced an explosive volcanic eruption around 1750. And even more recently, specifically on August 17, 1890, the Mono Lake complex displayed an episode of volcanic unrest. That day, a series of earthquakes struck beneath the center of the lake, only to be seemingly followed by the brief appearance of vents degassing to such a high level from underwater that it not only rose above the lake water, but also was visible from afar. This apparently occurred right next to Niget Island. While no other episodes of unrest have occurred since then, it, along with the still active fumarole and hot springs in the complex, are a reminder that the Mono Lake complex is still active. This complex will always produce explosive activity that can disrupt air traffic during the initial phase of any future eruption, along with sometimes producing Merapi-type volcanic eruptions that result in pyroclastic flows being generated. As a result, the U.S. Geological Survey designated Mono Lake as a moderate threat volcano. Before I explain how long this volcano has existed, I want to first elaborate on its most scientifically intriguing feature. Whenever a major landslide occurs, regardless of its cause or location, it leaves behind an instantly recognizable landform known as Hummocky Terrain. Here is an example I filmed at Mount St. Helens. There is also this example in Washington's Lake Roosevelt and at Canada's Frank Slide. In each example, you see numerous small to medium-sized hills that represent blocks or combined chunks of material deposited from a major landslide. And now, I want to bring your attention back to Mono Lake, specifically on Paoha Island. Note the occurrence of a major landslide scarp and hummocky terrain on its western side. The area which collapsed formerly only had an average slope of 3 degrees, meaning it shouldn't have collapsed, so what happened here? The answer is that this island in the time span of less than a year during the 18th century rose by a whopping 415 feet or 126 meters. This was caused by the expansion of a northward trending magma dike that generated a cryptodome, uplifting what were lake bottom sediments and causing landslides to occur due to the uneven uplift. But since this body of magma was in spots likely less than 50 feet below ground, part of the magma eventually erupted onto the surface in the northern half of the newly formed island, emplacing a 1.15 square kilometer or 284-acre rhyolitic lava flow. Of the 4 regional volcanoes, Mono Lake is the most recently to form. With our current understanding, it did not exist in any form until 13,300 years ago. Now, the Mono Lake volcanic field consists of 30 separate vents, not all of which are necessarily accounted for by its mere 5 known dated eruptions. This suggests that some of the undated vents may be older than what this video suggests. The first eruption involved tracky basalt lava erupting at 200 meters or 656 feet depth underneath the then glacial Lake Russell, forming the Black Point cinder cone. The next two eruptions also occurred underwater, forming small dacite lava domes in a series of phreatic explosion craters in 100 and 1200 CE. A large rhyodacite coulee constructed Neget Island in 1400, and a cryptodome uplifted Paoha Island, eventually giving way to a rhyolite lava flow around 1750. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member Gina for supporting my work.